How many people think they're creative? How many people think they're creative geniuses? Usually nobody in an audience believes that they're creative geniuses, and it's usually about 30 to 40% of people think they're creative, and that holds true across the country. I didn't think I was creative. In fact, I kind of hated myself. I grew up in a house where the walls reverberated with rage. My mom would scream at me with no notice, and my dad would throw furniture all the time. Every night, there was furniture flying across the living room. 9 years old, when they divorced, I realized that I hated myself. And I felt so desperate to be that little girl that I remembered at 2 or 3 years old who had joy. I remember being bubbly and happy and giggly, and none of that little girl. I couldn't find her inside me. And at 12, I started drinking to dull that pain. And I started smoking pot to dull that pain. When I got into high school, I would start the day at 7-Eleven with a fifth of vodka and a big gulp full of Orange Crush. I would dump out half, pour in the fifth. The Orange Crush, I believed, would obscure the smell of vodka, and I'd go through the day drinking in high school. I turned 16 and I took a ceramics class. And from the moment I touched the clay, I felt it. I felt this opportunity to engage in something where I could put all of these feelings I was feeling about myself that I was so ashamed of, the sadness and the emptiness, and I could put it into the clay and something would come of it. And it was the first time that I really discovered myself through a creative endeavor. That started me on the road of discovery, because I knew that if I stuck with art, even if it was clay, if it was painting, if it was drawing, I could put myself into it. I felt like it gave my life meaning I hadn't had before. It's an interesting thing because most people don't think they're creative, yet we know for a fact that 98% of five-year-olds are creative geniuses. In the 60s, George Land created a test for NASA. NASA wanted to attract the most creative people for their space program, and it was a wild success. So wild that George Land decided to test children. The first time he tested children, 98% of those five-year-olds tested as creative geniuses, and he decided to follow this group through their lives and test them every 5 years. At the age of 10, when these kids were 10, he gave them the same test. About 38% of them were testing as creative geniuses, which shocked him. And then at 15, he tested them again, and only 12% of them were creative geniuses. Shocked everyone. This test, same test, has been given to children millions of times since the 60s, all reproducing the same results. Through our education system, we are trained out of our creativity. What I've learned is when you're teaching someone to be creative, you're not teaching them how to draw. You're not teaching them the skill of painting. That's like math, that's a skill. You do it enough, you get good at it. What I'm teaching them is to believe in themselves. When you tell a child of any age that what matters is that they express themselves, you're setting them free, because they are in an environment where they're taught to mimic. They're taught to fit in, not just by our education system. They're taught by their parents. They're taught by their friends. Fit in. You'll make us all more comfortable if you fit in. And in art, it's not about fitting in. It's about expressing yourself. It's about expressing what matters. We're not here to fit in. We're not here to be like everyone else. So if you tell me you're not creative, I say, you've been brainwashed. Thank you, I'm Sara Young. If you're interested in infusing more creativity in your culture, you can reach me through my website, spikeofalltrades.com.